press the bell icon on the YouTube app to never miss a video from News Laundry.
There's news, there's sense, and there's nuisance. This show is all about that last bit. It's Diwali week, the festival of diyas and mithais and puja. The day of victory of good over evil, victory of light over darkness. We'll get to the light in a bit, but before that, let's talk of the darkness. Last week, a gruesome murder in Lucknow hit the headlines. Kamlesh Tiwari, former working president of the Akhil Bharat Hindu Mahasabha, was killed at his home in Lucknow. Six people have been arrested so far and five are from Surat. According to the police, two accused, Ashfaq Hussain and Moinuddin Pathan, killed Kamlesh to avenge certain statements he allegedly made against Prophet Muhammad in the past. The murderers were apparently also radicalized by Maulana in Surat. Some TV channels decided to use Kamlesh's murder to fan further communal passions by inviting guests like this.
Will you please come out and condemn the killing?
Deserved this fate.
That was Abdul Razak Khan. We looked up this guy to figure out why exactly he's on a debate about a murder case. What's his locus standi in the whole issue? Times Now and Republic introduce him as a political analyst. Both channels have invited him to speak on Daud, on PMC fraud, on Praful Patel, on Modi-Trump meet, on Howdy Modi, on Pakistan, on India's moon mission, and India's economy too, for Christ's sake.
India's economy is nosediving towards recession, despite you getting food at 4 times less.
Basically, the Johnny Lever of news debates, whose only purpose is to make the anchor look good with his silly antics. Why are we even surprised? Anyway, all the panelists on Republic just look like extras in Arnab's shit show. Back to Abdul Razak. Some channels also introduce him as a JDS spokesperson. Now, I called up the JDS spokesperson in Karnataka and I was informed that Abdul Razak is a party supporter and that he's not even a member of the party, leave alone being a spokesperson. Literally anyone can come on TV channel as a supporter. Even you. Seriously, try it. It's a lucrative option and all you have to do is talk crap on television. Some other web searches also showed that Abdul Razak Khan ran on a BSP ticket in Karnataka. Now, I called up the BSP convener in Karnataka and he told me that people like Abdul Razak Khan can basically just get a ticket in a state where the party has no political significance, like Karnataka. So, Abdul Razak became a JDS supporter just like that. And he got a BSP ticket just like that. And now, he's a TV news expert just like that. No real achievements to speak of, which obviously make him the best candidate for Republic and Times Now. And so he continues to speak on Swadeshi Diwali, whatever that means, Daud, and even elections.
Our Indian carrier is financed all in our country. Sir, look at the economic condition.
Any decent channel or media organization would distance itself from a man who justifies murder. Any decent channel would want nothing to do with someone who openly condones violence. But if you're Republican Times Now, you keep giving such people more platform. So the next time Arnab and his chelas talk of tukre tukre gang, anti-national elements, you the viewer should keep in mind who the real Break India gang is. Some other TV channels also used Kamlesh's death to play the same old games.
Mombatti gang, aaj kaha hai? क्या उनकी मोमबत्तियां पिघल गई हैं या वो अवार्ड वापसी गैंग कहां है जो आज तक बाहर नहीं निकला
हर बात पर तख्ती लेकर सड़कों पर उतरने वाले असहिष्णुता गैंग आज चुप क्यों है बताएं वो
क्या अगर कोई व्यक्ति मारा जाएगा तो उसका धर्म देख के ये लोग बाहर आएंगे
सो व्हेन देयर इज अ मर्डर इन वेस्ट बंगाल इट इज ममता बनर्जीज फॉल्ट बट व्हेन देयर इज अ मर्डर इन यूपी इट इज द फॉल्ट ऑफ लुटियंस लिबरल्स Not Yogi ji or state administration. It is the Lutyens liberals that should be blamed.
But the biggest question here is, where's the candlelight lobby now?
Moving on from this darkness to light, there's one person who's shown in all of this while battling a terrible tragedy.
एक सवाल मेरा पहले सुनिए
जी.
पहले मेरा एक सवाल सुनिए
जी.
सुनिए, हिंदू मुसलमान का शब्द आपने उठाया, हमने नहीं उठाया. आपने उठाया
जी.
तो हमको गुमराह कर रहे हो. जब हम कहते हैं कुछ नहीं, हम तुमको जवाब देंगे
जी.
आपने उठाया, हमने नहीं उठाया. और फिर आपने क्या कहा कि आप हिंदू मुसलमान करके दंगा कराना चाहते
नहीं,
क्या चाहते हो आप लोग?
मैंने ये नहीं कहा.
पागल समझ रखा हमको बेकूफ.
कुसुम जी, आपकी भावनाओं
आप कहते हो कि हिंदू मुसलमान पहले हुआ था और फिर हमसे कहते हो हिंदू मुसलमान करके दंगा कराना चाहती हो. खेलना बंद कर दो.
नो वन कुड हैव पुट इट बेटर देन कमलेश'स मदर कुसुम तिवारी. शी वाज बेसिकली बीइंग हाउंडेड बाय न्यूज चैनल्स व्हाइल शी वाज मॉर्निंग. In all of this, she had some really sharp things to say that I sure hope our news channels walas are listening to.
सरकार के खिलाफ बोल नहीं सकते, जनता के खिलाफ कब बोल सकते हो? तो बोलिए खुदकुशी से, और किसने मना किया? तो बोलिए, सरकार के खिलाफ बोलोगे चैनल बंद हो जाएगा.
More power to her and people who can see through these TV news channels that use gruesome murders and deaths to forward their agenda. Moving on, as we record this show, election results in Haryana and Maharashtra are being declared. It seems most of the channels got it quite off except India Today. India Today waited and presented their exit poll result for Haryana a day after everyone did. Arnab decided to take a swipe at India Today for doing this.
दूसरी बात यह है कि लोग फोन करके बोल रहे हैं आपके महाराष्ट्र दिखा दिया, आपने हरियाणा दिखा दिया, तक वालों के पास नहीं है क्या? तो मैं क्या करूं भाई, तक वालों के पास नहीं होगा या तक वाले ने इतना विश्लेषण नहीं किया होगा, प्रॉब्लम होगी उनकी. मैं उनकी कोई जिम्मेदारी नहीं ले सकता.
अर्नब, इफ आज तक इज तक वाला चैनल, व्हाट इज रिपब्लिक, लिक वाला चैनल? Arnab's Republic, among some other channels, projected a complete decimation of Congress and a BJP sweep. On the day of the election results, it was India Today that was having the last laugh.
Rajdeep, can you join me, please, in front? The last video.
I didn't want to come while you were talking about the other channels, because I think
we should. There are a bunch of noisy journalists.
I won't say
have
that.
Very little understanding of Indian politics.
Okay,
let's call Pradeep Gupta, please. Where is he? Can we call?
Where are our numbers?
Where are our numbers? Haryana numbers. No, our numbers are on the screen. You see, it's an exact poll.
Okay.
All you need to do is to know the exact numbers. Is to watch the TV to know what the numbers are.
As we record this show, the trends show that India Today got it quite right with their numbers on Haryana, even though they waited for a day to put them out. Good show, India Today, and Pradeep Gupta, who conducted the Access My India poll. Other news channels, please learn something. And don't do this, it's embarrassing.
And the Republic exit poll is projecting a double sweep for the NDA in Maharashtra and Haryana.
So if this result goes the way many people are assuming it will the opposition concede that Moditva is an unassailable plank and that people are voting for Ek Bharat Shresh Bharat?
Non-Jat face is sweeping Jat-dominated Haryana.
Haryana mein BJP ki prachand jeet hogi. अपने दम पर पार्टी जो है 72 सीटें हासिल कर रही है. विपक्ष का सुपड़ा साफ एक तरीके से बीजेपी कर रही है.
That this election is foregone in its conclusion. Do you believe that Narendra Modi and Amit Shah have been able to convince the voter that they're in the best hands possible at this time?
Well, that's where we depend on Ipsos, and that's where we believe that Ipsos is the most credible polling agency that we have seen.
In Haryana, look at the jump for the BJP in just the last 5 years.
याद होगा आपको इसी स्टूडियो में इसी शाम को शाम 7 बजे हमने एक्सिट पोल दिखाया था और कहा था कि नरेंद्र मोदी की अगुवाई में अगली सरकार बनेगी और बड़ी जीत होगी भारतीय जनता पार्टी की.
Our favorite hashtag of the week is #ParkItemBomb. Yeah, this guy after the flop Bhai versus Bhai has a new show. We call it #PoonawalaNautankiBomb. That's all the nuisance we have for you this week. We'll be back next week. Till then, stay mad. That's the only way. Wish you all a very, very happy Diwali. Hope you have lots of sweets, light lots of diyas, and do puja and play cards and do everything that's fun. I know that this was a really short episode and not very detailed, but that's because it was election time, it was results time, so all of us were really busy. As you know, we're a very small team of 1, 2, 3 people, so it can get a little tough for us to pull this off every week, which is why you need to support us and subscribe to newslaundry.com. Basically, we don't depend on ad money or government money to keep our boat floating. We depend on subscription money. So if you guys subscribe, we may be able to get ourselves a bigger team and do better shows and be more on time and maybe even longer shows. So if you want more of Newsance, you have to subscribe. Please log on to newslaundry.com/subscription and subscribe to News Laundry. Urge your friends to subscribe to News Laundry, or maybe give a News Laundry subscription as a gift of Diwali to your friends and family. If you like this show, please do consider supporting newslaundry.com, because it is with your support that we guys can get better. Not with the support of Ambani ji, or not with the support of Modi ji. Thank you all. Have a great Diwali.